recent world events such as the pandemic have raised the question of how people will return to their offices and how best to keep offices and public spaces safe for staff and visitors. There's also a growing need for reconfiguring traditional office spaces for efficiency of use.
Going into 2020, the objective of companies was really to optimize the space usage by cramming more and more people into as small of a space as possible to make sure you're getting the most out of your space, that you don't have unproductive empty space. The goal is to cut down on your facility cost, make sure that you have a full office, and at the same time, you don't lose productivity by having people unhappy with the situation at hand. The pandemic hitting wouldn't have been a very good selling point to say you're trying to cram as many people into as small of a space as possible, because obviously there's the whole social distancing and the contagion to worry about. The new step has been to try and make sure that you have more space per employee to make sure that you can enforce social distancing, you have fewer people in the office, you make sure they're all going in the same direction in a building to avoid unnecessary collisions that could spread the virus. So that was the change in how you were looking at an office, from being a place where you're trying to make every square foot productive to actually ensuring that your employees are safe now while maintaining a degree of productivity. Now, more than ever, it's important to make sure that you get your office layout correct, because you have one chance to get it wrong. If you bring in too many employees and they can't find space in the building, they're not going to want to come back into the office. If you come into the office and it's empty and there's no one there, then why did you go through the whole process of coming into the office in the first place? So it's more important than ever to find out how people are using the space and to make the adjustments to have the new hybrid working environment correct for the type of employees that you have.
Office space monitoring technology, and using the data derived from it, is critical in providing flexible ways of returning to workplaces and supporting staff.
There are newer, more high-tech solutions that you can use to find out what the space requirements are for your employees to be productive and to bring them back into the office. That can range from basic motion sensors or accelerometers that tell you when someone is actually at a seat or when a space is occupied, to more sophisticated headcount sensors that you mount on the ceilings that can really tell you how many people are in a specific space, which is very important to find out how long people are waiting for the elevator, for example, or in meeting rooms. How many people do you have there? Are they wandering about? Are they all sitting in close proximity? So with that technology, you can really find out how are the employees that are coming back to the office using this space. Because you really want to make sure that not only are you getting that first guesstimate correct, but also that you can adapt to changes in how the employees use the office. Because obviously the first wave coming back into the office, they might be looking at it, you know, fleeing from loud screaming children at home, and all they want to have is something quiet in the office. Or it could be the social butterflies who want to have that interaction with their colleagues again that they've been missing out over the past year. But if you have unassigned seating, which is kind of the future of the hybrid office, how do people adjust to that? If you come into an office and you're looking for John, for example, he might not be there, he might be there, he might be on a different floor or a different seat. So if you come into the office and you spend 15, 20 minutes looking for someone and you can't find them, why did you come in the first place? If you come into an office and you're trying to find a vacant seat, but you spend 15 minutes looking for one, again, why would you come into the office for that? You really need technology to facilitate that transition to a hybrid office. So if you have a mobile app or a reservation system with which you can actually book a seat, where you can search for your colleagues and find out, hey, who's in the office, where are they? Then you can come in on the same day, reserve a seat next to them. So you can facilitate that transition to a hybrid workplace without losing productivity by people not knowing where to go, who's in the office, and not being able to work productively. When making that transition from the old office concept to the more modern or newer one, you need that technology to really facilitate it. But change management is extremely important. If you're coming into an office and all of a sudden there's little sensors under the desk and on the ceiling and everywhere, a lot of employees might get the feeling that they're being watched. And so it's very important to convey to the employees that it's not the employee himself who's being monitored or watched, but it's the space, to find out how much of it is being used, to make sure that you're optimizing it to the benefit of the employee.
Using monitoring technology allows for the most efficient use of space across a company's departments and locations, often reducing the office footprint to meet the needs of a hybrid work environment.
In order to get wide acceptance of sensor technology, companies have had to be transparent about how they use the data. It's more important to know when they're occupying and how many people are occupying a space and for how long. This type of data allows the managers of buildings like Cushman and Wakefield to efficiently align the cost of managing the space so that it's on at the right time and it's available to make the employees more productive. That's really why employers need people to come into the office. Office spaces are one of the largest emitters of carbon in the world. So monitoring how many people are in the office space when you need to cool and heat the buildings is important as landlords and tenants all move toward becoming more sustainable and how they're working and how they're addressing climate change. This type of data is very important, and using this data, gathering it, and then making intelligent decisions about how to manage space, how to make space available, and how to provide the right services at the right time. It's very important not only to make employees and companies effective, but also to help reduce their carbon emissions in the marketplace. Resilience is very important in managing an office environment, especially when you have a crisis event, whether it's a weather-related event, a hurricane, an earthquake, or some type of civil disturbance that causes a problem in the workplace. Monitoring technology allows employers to respond quickly to these unforeseen events.
At Spacewell, our primary objective is really to make buildings work for you, instead of how it's been up until now, where effectively the employees were the ones making space productive. We're trying to turn that around and take it into the future, supplementing it with technology.
To learn more about using your space well, or to receive a free demo, visit us online at www.spacewell.com.